This is the Pavo Pico from BetaFPV, and I do have here in my hands version 2 or batch 2, which has the updated all-in-one board capable of running 3S batteries. Now, BetaFPV updated their Pavo Pico just a few months after the original release, which tells us two things. First of all, the Pavo Pico was so popular that they had to have sold through their original production run literally in a matter of weeks. And second of all, even though YouTube is full of Pavo Pico reviews, a lot of those reviews are going to be missing some critical information since version 2 wasn't out at that time. I do have the DJI O3 version, but you can also get this for Walksnail or the original Caddx Vista. And I also have the version with an external TBS crossfire receiver, but all of these come with ELRS on board. So if you want to save a little bit of money, go with ELRS. I'm going to let you know what's new, what's changed with version 2 of the Pavo Pico. I'm going to let you know how to run 3S batteries safely. I'm going to let you know which batteries you should choose. I'm going to give you some tips on assembling the Pavo Pico in order to avoid jello in your footage. And I'm going to let you know how it flies on both 2S and 3S batteries. As always, there will be timestamps in the video description below, so feel free to jump ahead if you're looking for something specific. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a like. It really helps me out. Thanks. The biggest difference with batch 2 of the Pavo Pico is the updated all-in-one board. It has 20 amp ESCs instead of the 12 amp ESCs on the version 1, and it's rated for 3S instead of 2S. That's a huge advantage even if you don't plan on running 3S, because more powerful ESCs means you have a little bit of headroom, and if you get something stuck in the props like a battery lead or some grass or something, you're less likely to burn up an ESC. It also has a 9 volt 2 amp BEC built into the all-in-one board, where the version 1 was powered directly from the LiPo. The problem with the original design was that the O3 requires 7 volts to operate normally, and on micros like this, a lot of people will fly their batteries down to below 7 volts, which means video feed could become unreliable and you could get brownouts whenever your battery dipped below 7 volts. I don't have version 1 of the Pavo Pico, but if you're flying version 1, let me know if that's an issue. I know it's a potential issue. Now there's a plug on the board for the DJI wiring harness, so if you need to remove it or change it, you can do that easily without having to solder anything. The all-in-one board also extends out the rear a little bit, where the battery pigtail and the USB plug are mounted, and what that means is it's so much easier to plug in this little USB pigtail. The all-in-one board also has 16 megabytes of black box, and it has more UARTS to give you more flexibility to run a GPS or an external receiver if you want to. The new board does weigh a little bit more. It's 5.5 grams instead of 4.2 grams. Just because you can do something doesn't always mean you should. And even though the power system is now capable of handling 3S batteries, these 14,000 kV motors were designed for 2S. So if you just plug in a 3S battery, you're going to be more likely to burn out a motor, and you can expect those motors to have a shorter lifespan. There's two ways you can run 3S safely on the Pavo Pico. First of all, you could swap out these motors for something with a lower kV, but that's not realistic because aside from the cost, BetaFPV has used a unique 3-hole pattern and there's not very many motors available. The easiest way to run 3S would be just to run a motor output limit in Betaflight. For example, a limit of 67% would give you roughly the same kV, so there wouldn't be any extra load on your motors. When you're deciding where to set that motor output limit on the Pavo Pico, just remember that this little drone was designed to be a lightweight, cinematic cruiser. So if you want to set up your Pavo Pico to rip balls, more power to you. But be prepared to replace prop guards, props, canopies, everything, because the Pavo Pico is not very durable. I like to have the option of running both 2S and 3S batteries. For example, 2S is great for indoors or slow cinematic flights, and 3S is great for faster outdoor flights. The easiest way to do that is to set up 2S and 3S PID profiles in Betaflight, and the appropriate profile will be applied according to which battery you connect. Here's how I do that in Betaflight. First, I copy PID profile 1 to PID profile 2. In PID profile 1, under cell count, I change it to 2S battery. That way it'll automatically be selected when I plug in a 2S LiPo. Then I name this profile 2S under PID profile name. That way my OSD will tell me which PID profile is active. In PID profile 2, I change cell count to 3S battery, which means that this profile will be activated whenever I plug in a 3S battery. Then I change the motor output limit to something between 70 to 75%. Remember, at about 67%, you'll be running the same equivalent KV as you would be on 2S batteries. Then I name this profile 3S. Finally, in the OSD tab, I activate PID profile name so that the OSD will display the name of the PID profile that is active. This last step is technically not necessary. It's just something I like to do so I can be sure I'm running the right settings for the right battery. With this setup, I'm able to run my 2S and 3S LiPos interchangeably, and I can just plug in a 3S LiPo whenever I want a little more power and a little longer flight time without killing these motors, because after all, they were designed to be run on 2S. I've run all of these different battery sizes and shapes in my Pavo Pico, but I did have to modify the battery tray. For something that's roughly the same size, like these 2S batteries, I was able to just snip the plastic in the battery tray and they fit right in and are held nice and snug. For larger batteries like this 650 2S or this 453S, you really have to cut the battery tray and then feed a battery strap underneath. BetaFPV has some images on the product page on their website which shows you how to do this. The battery strap I'm using weighs in at less than half a gram. And it's actually a Velcro cable tie. You can get a roll of these on Amazon, cut them to size, they're super useful. You can feed your battery strap underneath the plastic tray like so, and then it'll hold just about any size of battery completely securely. BetaFPV advertises the Pavo Pico's weighing in at 100 grams. Mine actually weighs 104.4, but that's with an ND filter, with an external crossfire receiver and antenna, and a battery strap. With a Tattoo 452S, it's 105.4. With a Race Day Quads 525 2S, it's 106. With a Race Day Quads 650 2S, it's 107.8. With a Race Day Quads 525 3S, it's 119.3. And with a CNHL 453S, it's 120.6. When you choose batteries for your Pavo Pico, you really have to pay attention to size. Think long and skinny, not short and fat. And weight. BetaFPV designed the Pavo Pico with that 452S in mind to be lightweight, nimble, and easy to fly indoors and outdoors to get the best experience possible from your digital FPV system. If you put too heavy a battery on your Pavo Pico, you'll negate all the advantages of that lightweight design and it won't fly very well. So remember that using a larger 2S or 3S battery will give you more power and longer flight times, but the quad will fly worse as it gets heavier, so don't overdo it. For 2S batteries, I think you want to stick to something between 450 to 650 milliamps maximum, and for 3S, you probably want something between 300 to 550 milliamps maximum. Anything over that, and the Pico is just going to get too heavy and it won't fly very well. Remember, the determining factor here is weight, and different brands can have different weights, so pay attention to weight when you're shopping for batteries. Of all the batteries I've tested, the ones I run the most are the 452S that BetaFPV gives you with the drone and the 453S from CNHL. I love the extra flight time and the extra pep that I get out of this 453S. But it's so heavy that it actually flies much better with the 452S that BetaFPV ships with the drone. Big surprise, because they did design it to be flown with this battery. When choosing your batteries, remember that the Pavo Pico was designed to be lightweight and it flies so much better when it's lightweight. If you're running the DJI O3 and you're getting jello in your footage, there's a few things you can do to avoid it. When you're mounting the VTX assembly to the frame, be sure to tighten those screws securely, but don't over-tighten. Those rubber grommets need to be held in place firmly, but not be overly compressed in order to do their job and prevent vibrations from reaching your camera. I also used an O-ring right here between the camera mount and the camera itself, this gives a little bit more protection against vibrations reaching that camera. It's worked pretty well for me so far. You want to use the original screws that came with the DJI camera, not the short ones that BetaFPV gives you. Make sure and tighten down the camera screw and cinch down that O-ring pretty firmly. If you don't tighten it enough, that camera is going to have a little bit of play and you're going to introduce more vibrations than you're preventing. But then on the other hand, if you tighten it down too much, that O-ring isn't going to do anything. So it's a question of finding the sweet spot, and you'll need to play around with that a little bit. I also used a zip tie on the camera cable itself and folded it over sideways so that it's held in place behind the camera and in front of the air unit, and it's not putting any pressure on the camera at all. BetaFPV does give you this little plastic piece for running the stock O3 antenna out the back. I wouldn't recommend doing that because this quad is so sensitive to vibrations. It just seems like it would be harder to tune if you had a relatively large antenna hanging off the back. If you assemble the Pavo Pico with care and patience, it's pretty likely that you're going to get some nice, clean, jello-free 4K footage from your DJI O3 air unit. And as long as there's no wind, it's a fun little cruiser, and you can get some super high-quality footage both indoors and out. On 2S, it's a great little cruiser, and it's super stable, and on 3S, it's a little more peppy and has longer flight times. If I'm flying outdoors for fun, I'll use a 3S battery, and if I'm trying to get some usable cinematic shots with that DJI O3 camera, I'll fly on 2S because it's just easier to fly in a smooth cinematic style. I'll leave you guys with some flight footage. Let me know what you think of the Pavo Pico and if you prefer flying it on a 2S or 3S and what your all-up weight is. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.